thank you very very much. I, on behalf of Hindu Yuva, welcome everyone for the Ganesh Chaturthi celebration. So I hope we all have our groups. So parents can join their kids with the respective group, and everybody can be please seated. So Ganesh Chaturthi, as you know, is an appearance day festival of Lord Ganesha. It's the day when he appeared. Back in Maharashtra, India, it's a major festival. Millions of people come together. They get Ganesha deities in their homes, in their communities, and worship him for several days. It's a massive effort there. Here at AIIMS, it's our humble attempt for second year in a row to recreate that kind of atmosphere. We understand we are far away from millions, no doubt about that. But our spirits are high, enthusiasm is fresh, and the reciprocation is awesome. So I would like to gratefully thank all of you. So at this point, I would like to invite Ankit, who is Hindu Yuva President, to brief us to initiate the Ganesh Utsav Festival. Thank you very much.
Ganpati Bappa!
Gorya!
Namaste all. I'm really happy to see you all here. It was really nice response from all of you. Thank you so much. Actually, this is first time we are doing this. We are reorganizing the campus, Hindu Yuva at ISU. So Yuva stands for Youth, for Unity, Virtues and Action. So it's a campus organization. So today is the Ganesh Chaturthi, and we know it is celebrated in Maharashtra in a big way. And we are trying to celebrate, as Anguji said, in a smaller way here. So it's a religious ceremony, we all know. And the religious aspect of it, we all will celebrate here. We'll all see how to worship Ganesha. Kids will see what is the importance of it and all. But if you know the history of this festival in Maharashtra, it has a great social aspect of it. Earlier, it was celebrated in Maharashtra and all over India in a small way, like at their home. But when Lokmanya Tilak came and he made it public, so he made it the matter of pride, unity, and a show of strength, right? So this is a social aspect which our festival brings to us. So that's where Hindu Yuva comes into the picture. Other than religious and rituals, we believe in social impact of the festivals and in general Hindu tradition and values. Hindu Yuva is a student initiative of an organization called Hindu Swayamsevak Sangh, which is a registered organization since 25 years. And the idea of the organization is to preserve, practice, promote and protect Hindu Dharma. By Hindu Dharma, we mean traditional values and culture. Right? So by preserve, we mean we should know what is there, what is Ramayana, what is Mahabharata. To kids, who told Gita to whom? Anyone?
I know both.
Who? Ram told to Sita? Oh, Arjuna told to Shri Krishna, right?
No.
What then? Oh yeah, so, that's great. So we all know here outside India, that's great. Yeah. Have a big hand for this. So this is about preserving our culture, values, tradition. Right? So we should know what is there in our great scriptures, in our systems. But second is practice, because if we know what is there, if we don't practice, then there's no meaning, right? We should not waste food. We know it is in our scriptures. A lot of good things in our traditions. So practice is important, and that's where the Hindu Yuva and the HSS Hindu Sangh comes into the picture. We have a small weekly session. One is called Shakha in community. In AIIMS, it is not there right now. It is in Dimai. So it's a 1 hour activity where kids come with the family and they learn some shlokas, they learn some good things and the value system, samskars and all, weekly. So it leaves a great impact on them. And the second come promote. So this is what we are doing right now. So we know, we practice at individual level, but we should promote this system to others. So there are some activities of HSS like Raksha Bandhan Utsav. So you know what they do on Raksha Bandhan? So we all know what is Raksha Bandhan. What is Raksha Bandhan, any kid? Do you know Rakhi? You know, right? That's great, okay. So what do we do? So the kids from different shakhas, different members of HSS, they go to different public departments like police, and fire department, and they tie Rakhi to them, the non-Hindus, foreigners, and they explain what does it mean. So you protect us and we are grateful to you. So that's how we celebrate Universal Brotherhood Day on the Raksha Bandhan. So that's the value system of Hinduism which we applied in the larger context here. Same way we celebrate Guru Vandana. So kids go to their school and they tie some thread and they like respect their teachers and explain what do you mean to us. So this is all about promoting thing in a positive way. And protect, very small example, in California, in schools, there are a lot of bad things about Hinduism. They don't represent nicely. So HSS and Hinduvat took initiative, they formed a committee and tried to correct the things which are not represented correctly. So it's about protecting. Whenever it comes to protect our culture, we do that also. Yeah. So that's about the organization. And thank you so much for coming. And we shortly, I know the kids are very enthusiastic to open the bag.
Excited.
Yeah, but don't open the bag right now, otherwise it can get dry. And yeah, so follow the instructions given by the team leader and we'll have a wonderful day. Thank you.
As they were singing about meditation on Lord Ganesha, how can we meditate on someone? There are several ways. We can hear about that person. We can talk about that person. We can offer prayers, or we can serve. So hearing and speaking is a very powerful process. We have common experience. When we hear, oh, did you hear that? That movie is so nice. What happens immediately? Immediately there's a desire to go and watch it. When we hear, oh, did you taste that food in that restaurant, Indian Palace? Oh, is that nice? I liked it a lot. What happens? You meditate over it and you develop a desire to go and eat it. Similarly, if we expose ourselves to the positive vibrations in the form of glorification of Lord Ganesha, what will happen? We will increase and deepen our love and affection for the Lord. The natural feelings of gratitude will awaken for the Lord as we hear His glories. So for next 10 minutes, we'll try to hear about the various activities, His birth, how He acted in this world. Once upon a time, Mother Parvati, she wanted to go for a bath and there was no one. Lord Shiva had gone for a battle on behalf of demigods. She wanted someone to stay guard. She thought, should I call Nandi? No. He is very loyal to Lord Shiva, but what about me? Will he be loyal to me? Not sure. Whom should I call? She was wondering like that. Then what she did, she rubbed Chandan off her body. And from that, she made a very beautiful boy. That boy, she named as Ganesha. And Ganesha was instructed by his mother. Oh, my dear child, your name will be Ganesha. And I instruct you, please stand on guard as I am taking my bath and make sure no one enters. Her instruction was very explicit, very clear. No one should enter. Ganesha said, yes, Mataji, I will do what you say. He was a very obedient kid. What happened? Lord Shiva arrived, victorious in the battle, overjoyed with a desire to see his wife, Mother Parvati. He approaches. What is this? Is a person blocking my way? Ganesha said, stop! You can't go ahead. Lord Shiva was surprised and angry. Who is this who is blocking my way to enter me from my home? Enter into my home. Who is this boy? Filled with rage, he roared at Ganesha. Oh, impudent child, get out of my way or be ready to bear the consequence. Ganesha, fearless, obedient son, he told, I am not afraid of anything. I am an obedient son of my mother and I will not let you pass. Then bear the consequence. And saying that, Lord Shiva threw his trident and beheaded Ganesha. Hearing the commotion, all the shouting, all the cries, Mother Parvati, who was inside her chambers, she came running out. And what she sees? Her child, her beloved child Ganesha, is lying lifeless. Puzzled, she asked everyone, what happened? Lord Shiva said, this child was blocking my way. Oh, my dear Lord, what you did? He's our son. Why did you do this to him? Lord Shiva was wonderstruck. Oh my God, what I did? What a mistake I did. Immediately he said, I will give back life to my son Ganesha by putting the head of the first sleeping creature who is sleeping with his head in the north. Saying that, he sent forth his ganas, Nandi and Atsitra, to find such a creature. And the first person they came upon was actually an elephant. So they took the head of the elephant and Lord Shiva revived Ganesha with an elephant head. That's how Lord Ganesha got his beautiful, beautiful feature of having an elephant head, as we see there. So Mother Parvati and Lord Shiva have two sons. Any one of you, I want the answer from the kids. Name of the two sons. Yes, say it loud.
Ganesh
and?
Kartik.
Any other options? Any other answers?
No.
Okay, one more. You can say. Kartikeya. Anybody other than that? Yes. Okay, so we have unanimously agreed Kartikeya and Ganesha are the two sons. Thank you. So, parents wanted to test the skills and expertise of their kids. Just like today, your parents will be seeing your expertise in making clay Ganesha.
गणाध्यक्षाय धीमहि गुणशरीराय गुणमण्डिताय गुणेशानाय धीमहि गुणातीताय गुणाधीशाय गुणप्रविष्टाय धीमहि एकदन्ताय वक्रतुण्डाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय भालचन्द्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि चतुराय गानप्राणाय गानान्तरात्मने गानोत्सुकाय गानमत्ताय गानोत्सुकमनसे गुरुपूजिताय गुरुदैवताय गुरुकुलस्थायिने गुरुविक्रमाय गुह्यप्रवराय गुरवे गुणगुरवे गुरुदैत्यगणक्षेत्रे गुरुधर्म सदाराध्याय गुरुपुत्र परित्रात्रे गुरुपाखंड खंडकाय गीत साराय गीत तत्वाय गीत गोत्राय धीमहि गूढ़ गुल्फाय गंधमत्ताय गोजय प्रदाय धीमहि वक्रतुण्डाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय भालचन्द्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि
वक्रतुण्डाय
ग्रंथाय ग्रंथगेयाय ग्रंथांतरात्मने गीतलीनाय गीताश्रयाय गीतवाद्यपटवे गेयचरिताय गायकवराय गंधर्वप्रियकृते गायकाधीन विग्रहाय गंगाजल प्रणयवते प्रणयाय गौरी प्रवणाय गौरभावाय धीमहि गोसहस्त्राय गोवर्धनाय गोपगोपाय धीमहि गुणातीताय गुणाधीशाय गुणप्रविष्टाय धीमहि एकदंताय वक्रतुंडाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय भालचंद्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि एकदंताय वक्रतुंडाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय भालचंद्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि
symbolism in Ganpati, why Ganpati has an elephant head, why he is called Vignesh, why we worship him before we go to their exam, right? We'll talk a little bit about that and then we'll do a small puja for your own Ganpati. Everybody good?
No.
No. Ganpati Bappa!
Morya!
Big, very prominent. So that has very, very important significance. It shows us more eagerness to hear and less urge to speak. Very difficult. His mouth is so small, he's telling that, okay, calm down, don't speak so much, have big ears, listen first. So before being a good listener, we cannot be a good speaker. Any other part? Okay, now I'll ask you one question. You missed out, most of you missed out one personality while making Ganesha.
Yeah.
Who is that?
Anyone could tell this?
There is one personality whom you missed out while making Ganesha.
Ali
Adi
is also raising
it. What's your name?
Adi.
Shweta. Shweta is saying mouse. How many of you made mouse?
Great.
So.
हरता दुख हरता वार्ता विघ्नाची पूर्वी पूर्वी प्रेम कृपा जयाची सर्वांगी सुंदर कुटिशेंदुराची कंठी झळके माळ मुक्ता फळांची जय देव जय देव खचित फरा तुझ गौरी कुमरा चंदनाची उटी कुंकुम केशरा हिरे जडित मुकुट शोभ तो भरा तृण झुणती नुपुरे चरणी घागरिया जय देव जय देव पीतांबर फणिवर बंधना सरल सोंड वक्र तुंड त्रिनयना दास रामाचा वाट पाहे सदना संकटी पावावे निर्वाणी रक्षावे सुरवर वंदना जय देव जय देव जय देव जय देव जय मंगल मूर्ति हो श्री मंगल मूर्ति दर्शन मात्रे मन स्मरणे मात्रे मन कामना पूर्ति जय देव जय देव मात्रे मन स्मरण